afternoon. My name is Melissa Roy, and I'm the college's Chief Diversity Officer. Welcome to honoring Dr. Frances E. Pratt at the second annual Women's Empowerment Draft. We are recording today's program and we'll post it on the college's website next week. Today is International Women's Day. Every year around the world on March 8th, people of all genders celebrate the social, economic, cultural, and political achievements of women. We at Rockland Community College are happy to join in this global celebration. The Women's Empowerment Draft is a SUNY project that honors women who have worked diligently to make our communities better. When asked to participate in this Women's History Month project, we jumped at the opportunity and immediately identified Dr. Frances E. Pratt as the woman we wanted to honor for her life achievements and contributions to our community. International Women's Day was the perfect occasion for us to do just that. I've known Dr. Pratt since I was a member of the Nyack NAACP Youth Council and AXO participant. So it is a privilege to be able to say, on behalf of Rockland Community College, with our first pick, we take Dr. Frances E. Pratt from South Nyack, New York, in the Women's Empowerment Draft. We will cover more about the Women's Empowerment Draft later in the program. Let's start by watching a video about Dr. Pratt. When asked how she wants to be remembered, Dr. Frances Pratt stated,
"I would like to be remembered by having tried to be a servant of God and a servant of humankind."
If you could assign lyrics to the story of Dr. Pratt's life, they would reflect her favorite song.
If I could help somebody as I pass along, then my living will not be in vain.
I can help somebody while I'm singing their soul. You know my living shall not be in vain.
Dr. Pratt is the immediate past president of the Nyack branch of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, also known as the NAACP. She served as president of the Nyack branch for 40 years. Her resolve to confront racial injustice was born during her childhood in the South.
My experience as the president of the Nyack branch NAACP has also fulfilled one of my childhood dreams. And that came about as a result of me and my mother was during segregation in the South. We were on the bus, and we got on the bus, there were no more seats behind the color line. So we had to stand 6 miles all the way to Raleigh, North Carolina. And when we got there, my mother brought ice cream cone. And the clerk said, "You have to stand outside. You can't eat it in here." And from that moment, I said, if I ever grew up, I was going to do something about racial disparity. What makes the color of my skin different that I cannot be accepted as a human being.
Under her leadership, the Nyack branch worked with NAACP regional leadership and state, county, and town elected officials to address major areas of inequality facing African Americans. As president, Dr. Pratt organized the branch's signature programs, the annual interfaith service celebrating the life of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., and the annual Freedom Fund dinner spotlighting the contributions of community members and featuring national civil rights leaders. Both programs fostered the twin objectives of unity and social justice.
We have just become a beloved community behind our Freedom Fund dinners and our Martin Luther King programs, and we're just united. I can truly say what Julie Barnes says, yes, we are one.
The branch's membership dramatically increased during her tenure.
Now, when I took over the branch of the president, we had 25 members. That's all. And now I'm proud to say we have close to 800 members.
Dr. Pratt has been honored numerous times for her civil rights contributions. She was recognized with the National NAACP Heroine Award. She was inducted into the Rockland County Civil Rights Hall of Fame. She was recently granted a key to the county by the county executive, just to name a few. In her characteristically humble fashion, Dr. Pratt downplayed the many honors she received and focused on the grassroots successes of which she is proudest.
That was my greatest accomplishment, was the mentoring of the youth and the young adult.
Even after four decades of inspired leadership, Dr. Pratt contends that she received more than she gave.
I feel that NAACP did more of a difference in my life than what I actually did for the NAACP. Based on all of you, all the audiences that I ever come in contact with, allowed me to use my gifts, and by them allowing me to use my gift, it has enhanced my gifts far beyond what I could ever imagine.
Dr. Pratt's life is exemplified by her enduring passion to make the world a better place. She enrolled in RCC's nursing program due to her desire to help people.
Since I was not able to go to missionary college after I got married, and when they opened up the schools, the two-year colleges, and had a nursing program, that gave me an opportunity to still deal in the humanities and to be a servant to people. And that's why I wanted to be a nurse and studied in their nursing program. And I must say, that is one of the best programs that I has ever been started by government in my life.
Dr. Pratt is a proud alumna of Rockland Community College. She celebrated RCC's anniversaries, was honored as a woman of wisdom by the RCC Foundation, and has advised RCC presidents. Through her words and deeds, Dr. Pratt is inspiring the next cohort of caregivers, activists, and leaders across Rockland.
I just have tried to use my talents according to how God laid it out for me to do it.
Dr. Pratt, we love what you do and how you do it. Your legacy is based on your hard work and dedication, but also the many qualities that you exhibit. This is how we describe you.
Vigilant.
Leader.
Wise.
Ethical.
Principled.
Charming.
Formidable.
Savvy.
Empathetic.
Authentic.
Courageous.
Capable.
Classy.
Spiritual.
Activist.
Professional.
Tireless.
Elegant.
Sister.
Confident.
Dedicated.
Phenomenal.
Humble.
Inspirational.
Pioneer.
Icon. Living legend. Man, I get a little teary-eyed watching that montage. Kudos to our multimedia production team on preparing that touching video. The hats are multicolored and they are magnificent, but that's just the surface. The impact of Dr. Pratt's leadership and actions go much deeper. I've asked several members of the college community to reflect on Dr. Pratt's impact on Rockland County by talking about their own relationships with her. We will begin with Grant Valentine, who will be immediately followed by Dr. Kathy Hopkins. Mr. Valentine is a member of the Rockland Community College Board of Trustees. He also serves as a community outreach liaison for the board. Dr. Hopkins is the Dean of the School of Nursing, Health, and Wellness, and a professor of nursing.
Thank you, Melissa. I'm deeply humbled and honored to have been asked to say a few words about Dr. Francis Pratt. I met Dr. Pratt probably about 15 years ago at the Nyack Freedom NAACP dinners, which are extraordinary dinners. And when you meet Dr. Francis Pratt, her smiles without conditions is in her heart. She talks without interruption. The wisdom she imparts in you is just amazing. Francis gives without reason and cares without expectation. This is the beauty of Frances Pratt. She never grows tired of doing good for others, never stops caring, sharing her blessings, never stops touching the lives of others. We see her as our inspiration. As she keeps moving, praying, and smiling, turning stumbling blocks into stepping stones, building bridges of understanding that transcends cultural, social, political, and spiritual conversations through the different eyes. I have learned that the strongest people are not the ones who want to be in front of cameras or audiences, but those who win battles we know nothing about. They are our true defenders of the dream in our community. Francis Pratt has allowed us to see all those possibilities. There are people and moments in our presence that shape or decide our destiny. Under Francis Pratt's leadership, the NAACP has amassed over 120 plaques, awards, national recognitions. Her tireless work has led the way for civil rights, human rights of underserved and marginalized people of all colors. To watch her in action is inspirational, as she does it with elegance and eloquence, speaking up against discrimination, racial injustice, educational inequities for our children, and food insecurities in our communities. She's not a bystander to history, but an anchor institution in Rockland with an equity and justice lens for our community. In Rockland and throughout the country, we honor Dr. Frances Pratt as a living example of Black history for her qualities, accomplishments, and class. She is our symbol of resilience and triumph against the adversities, all the while being the heart of our community. Dr. Pratt is admired up close and at a distance throughout the region because she values the opinions and contributions of others and appreciates the creativity that evolves from our differences. She's open-minded, slow to complain, but quick to compliment another for a job well done, hardworking and committed to dismantling racism. Her courage is not an absence of fear, but a triumph over it. She has the courage to talk about the most difficult subjects in the most difficult settings. Because her faith in God is never left at the door. She lives by the words, "For the Lord, your God, goes with you, and he will never leave you nor forsake you." She knows progress does not move in a straight line. As we begin Women's History Month, Dr. Pratt, we can't always choose the music life plays for us, but we can choose how we dance to it. So please never, ever get tired of doing good for others. Never stop sharing your blessings, and never stop touching the lives of others, because we see you as an inspiration to our hearts and souls, as a civil rights story, as a human rights story, as a story of power of your voice. On behalf of the Board of Trustees of Rockland Community College, thank you for this opportunity to salute Dr. Frances Pratt for Women's History Month and the privilege to say a few words about my dear friend. Thank you, Dr. Pratt.
Hello there. Good afternoon, everybody. I am very honored to be able to speak about Frances at this ceremony, as Frances has been a major part of my professional life. I met Frances years ago as a young new graduate at the ripe old age of 20. At that time, Frances was the employee health nurse at Nyack Hospital, where she met all new employees. I'll never forget her first words to me. "Honey child, I am almost as Irish as you. My mother's father was Irish, which is why I have freckles." I had a lot more freckles back then. So then every year at my annual physical, Frances and I continued to bond over our ancestry and our freckles. It was a yearly event. When I reached a certain age, I wanted to expand my horizons and make sure I experienced healthcare outside of Rockland County, so I left the hospital. But I kept up with Frances when I would bump into her either at a restaurant or a civic event, and it was always like I was meeting a long-lost friend. Her ability to make people feel valued and appreciated is legendary. Once I started my family, my friends talked me back into coming back to the hospital. So I did, because it was much closer to home and it just made more sense. So once again, I needed a new employee physical at the hospital. And lo and behold, who was there but Frances to welcome me back, and she was as gracious as ever. Even though Frances, the physician you worked with, grumpily told me that I should never have left. And I had to listen to him for 20 minutes, and I won't mention names, but you know who I mean. And he was definitely the vinegar to your oil, and that's why everybody loved to see you in that office. Whenever I or other employees had a question related to employee protocols or anything else that people couldn't answer, we just knew we had to dial F for Frances. You knew you could depend on her for answers, solutions, and most of all, support. As a nurse, Frances set very high standards with her starched white dresses and her polished white clinics, as well as her kindness and grace. She could only wear a plain white hat back then. She couldn't wear any of her colored hats. And for those of you who do not know, clinics were a classic nurse's shoe that were very practical and comfortable, but definitely not fashionable. Back in the day, there was no such thing as wearing sneakers or scrubs for a nurse. Frances comes from that clinic generation. I was the nursemaid's generation, Frances. I followed you, and that's when they brought a little bit of style and a little bit of choice into the nurse's footwear. But both of our generations, and you'll laugh at this because every shift we had to polish those white shoes using that famous Sandy White nurse shoe polish. Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Now it's sneakers or clogs. So when Melissa told me about this ceremony honoring Frances, I reached out to a colleague from Nyack Hospital who is in HR. And these are her words. "Frances Pratt was a member of the Nyack Hospital family, now Montefiore Nyack, for over 50 years. She began her career in 1959 in the emergency department, and during her tenure in the ER, she held the position of head nurse. She also held the position of manager of employee health services for many years prior to her retirement in December 2011. Ms. Pratt was extremely dedicated to Nyack Hospital. She could always be counted on to provide her own unique viewpoint and insight to a situation in a very calm manner. Frances brought a sense of grace to the hallways of Nyack Hospital, and on special occasions could even be seen wearing one of her signature hats. Frances's influence was felt far beyond the walls of Nyack Hospital as she held leadership positions in many civic, religious, and nursing organizations throughout Rockland County. So Frances, we were only given a few minutes. So in conclusion, I want to say that I am honored to call you my mentor, my role model, and my friend over the years. You have surely left your mark on me as well as many in the nursing profession. We strive here at Rockland Community College in our nursing department to maintain the professional standards that you embodied as a nurse. And as we all know, good old fashioned values and morals are a necessity to bring to a great nurse, and you had them both. I honor you and congratulate you and wish you the best of luck. Thank you.
Grant and Kathy, thank you for those heartfelt and beautiful reflections. At Rockland Community College, we love to inject the arts into our programs. I asked Patty Maloney Titlin, the program director of the Visual and Performing Arts Department, to recommend a student to read a poem. Professor Maloney Titlin identified I, Beth Hernandez. I, Beth is a visual and performing arts student who plans to graduate in May 2021. She is reciting one of my favorite poems, Phenomenal Woman by Maya Angelou. Immediately following I, Beth's recitation, Fabiola Riobi will share her thoughts about Dr. Pratt's impact. Ms. Riobi is the Associate Provost for Academic Innovation, Online Education, and Global Opportunities. Hi, Beth.
My name is Ibeth Hernandez, and I am from the Performing Arts Department, and I will be reading Phenomenal Woman by the amazing Maya Angelou, and I hope you enjoy. Pretty women wonder where my secret lies. I'm not cute or built to suit a fashion model's size. But when I start to tell them, they think I'm telling lies. I say, it's in the reach of my arms, the span of my hips, the stride of my step, the curl of my lips. I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's me. I walk into a room just as cool as you please, and to a man, the fellows stand or fall down on their knees. Then they swarm around me, a hive of honey bees. I say, it's the fire in my eyes and the flash of my teeth, the swing in my waist and the joy in my feet. I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's me. Men themselves have wondered what they see in me. They try so much, but they can't touch my inner mystery. When I try to show them, they say they still can't see. I say it's in the arch of my back, the sun of my smile, the ride of my breasts, the grace of my style. I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's me. Now you understand just why my head's not bowed. I don't shout or jump about or have to talk real loud. When you see me passing, it ought to make you proud. I say, it's in the click of my heels, the bend of my hair, the palm of my hand, the need for my care. 'Cause I'm a woman, phenomenally, phenomenal woman. That's me.
Beautifully said, Ibeth. Thank you so much. And thank you so much, Melissa, for inviting me to participate on this extraordinary celebration and recognition of Dr. Frances Pratt. I am so excited and honored to be here. I was actually speaking to one of my friends who live out of state, and I was telling them about the celebration today. And I said, I'm so excited because I get to talk about Dr. Frances Pratt. And I was going on and on and on. And then she goes, okay, that's great, Fabiola. Well, who's Frances Pratt? And then instantaneously, the first words that came to my mind were graceful social justice. And that's what you've always been to me. And it also took me aback a little bit because it made me realize that for my entire life, I have taken for granted the fact that I've had this pristine example of what it meant to be someone who was not only committed to serving their community, committed to being a lifelong servant and educator, but who did it for everyone. And to me, that has been tremendous in my own development. Now, Dr. Pratt, I'm going to tell you this story that I'm sure you have no idea about. And I'm going to take you back many years ago because I was in seventh grade. And I remember it like yesterday because seventh grade was the time that I had the opportunity to get an identification card. And that card was the second card I ever got in my life with my name on it that I filled out the application for myself. And that was my Nyack NAACP Youth Council card. And I remember it like yesterday because seventh grade was also the time where I had to go for my confirmation. And during confirmation, you have to do so many hours of community service, but you also have to pick a name that embodies you, a name that you have to live up to, a name traditionally of a saint, right? A saint that you want to aspire to be like. And I chose the name Frances. And I remember, you know, my Catholic school principal at the time, Sister Stevens, said to me, oh, Fabiola, that's so exciting. Did you choose, you know, St. Francis of Assisi? And I said, no, not really. You know, I chose the name Frances for Frances Pratt of Nyack. And she was like, oh, well, why is that? And I said, because for the first time in my life, I met someone out of my family, outside of my immediate family, a Black woman who not only was in leadership, but was committed to the development and sincerely committed to my development as a young Black woman and provided resources and opportunities to make sure that I could achieve everything that I wanted to achieve. And I remember Sister Stephen looked at me and she said, you couldn't have chose better. And I say that to say, thank you. Thank you because even my own personal commitment now, as I've accomplished things in my life, and I look at what my trajectory is like and what I continue, what I wish for it to continue to be like, I take that and I model it after the exemplary role model you have been to people like me and to a lot of young Black girls in Rockland County. And as I'm going here now, I'm a mother. I have two daughters, age 11 and 7. It's a privilege of me, for me, to be a role model for them, to demonstrate to them what it looks like to be daring, graceful, ambitious, audacious, but most importantly, to be a servant leader committed to community development outside of oneself. And I've learned that by watching you all those many years. And so as I close, I want to leave you with a quote. And this quote comes from Christiana Campbell. And what Christiana Campbell said was, not many things last forever, except for eternity and the good things we've done. And you, Dr. Frances Pratt, your impact will last forever. So thank you again.
Yola, thank you for your lovely and sincere reflections. And Ibeth, thank you for your lovely recitation. In its second year, the Women's Empowerment Draft pays tribute to 32 women's empowerment icons through a colorful, football-inspired draft ceremony. The program asks, what if we celebrated women's history with the same enthusiasm as we root for professional athletics. The draft ceremony video was released today. It features female college students reframing the festivities as they choose to honor both historic trailblazers and living legends as if they were modern day superstars. In addition to the draft ceremony, a critical element of the Women's Empowerment Draft is the making of a mosaic. Immediately following the draft ceremony video, Sarah Macell and Essence Webb will tell us about their art project. Professor Macell is an instructor in the art department, and Essence is a photography student who expects to graduate in 2022.
What if we honored women's history the way we honor professional athletes?
Wow. SUNY ESF honors Grace Jones.
University of Albany honors Caroline Parker.
SUNY New Paltz honors Sojourner Truth.
Buffalo State honors Mary Burnett Talbert.
What if a month after the Super Bowl, we celebrated Super Women?
JCC honors Lucille Ball.
SUNY Delhi honors Alila Walker.
SUNY Adirondack honors Grace Hudowalski.
Binghamton University honors Pearl Primus.
What if we root for our home team by uprooting stories from our hometowns?
Purchase New York honors Rita Moreno.
Suffolk County Community College honors Hazel Dukes.
Ithaca honors Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
University at Buffalo honors Abby Raven.
What if violence against women was our worst losing record?
SUNY honors Breonna Taylor.
SUNY Brome honors Tarana Burke.
SUNY Old Westbury honors Maya Angelou.
Plattsburgh, New York honors Kyla Relaford.
What if male athletes wore our jerseys?
Falcon Community College honors Frances Pratt.
Fulton Montgomery Community College honor Elizabeth Cady Stanton.
Corning Community College honors Eileen Collins.
SUNY Rockport honors Annie Barrier Williams.
What if girls and boys traded cards with the faces of these superstars?
Alpha State honors Letitia James.
Oswego, New York honors Linda Cohen.
Tompkins-Cortland Community College honors Kamala Harris.
Alfred University honors Candace Wheeler.
What if less men trolled on us and more men rolled with us?
SUNY Oneata honors Yoko Ono.
SUNY Cortland honors Judy Heumann.
Erie Community College honors Kim Pagula.
Alfred University honors the living legend Kristen Beck.
What if we started a movement that caught on like a wave?
SUNY honors nurses and all other frontline healthcare workers.
Finger Lakes Community College honors Ella Baker.
Monroe County honors Hester Jeffrey.
Genesee Community College honors Michelle Obama.
What if we draft?
What if we draft?
What if we draft?
Hi, everyone. I'm Sarah Macell. I'm the photography instructor at RCC, and I'm co-chair of the Women's History Month alongside Natasha Lubarsky. It is such an honor to meet you, Dr. Pratt, and thank you for your many years of service. You are truly an example to all of us in the fight for racial justice. When Melissa introduced to our committee the Women's Empowerment Draft Project and suggested Dr. Pratt as our honoree, I volunteered my alternative processes photo class to paint the mural segment of the project. We met this past Friday on campus for a socially distanced session, and I took photos and videos of our work to share with you all now. In this course, we work in a variety of mixed art mediums. Five outstanding young women from the course spent hours hand painting each and every tile to capture Dr. Pratt's likeness. We spread out over two classrooms and wore masks to complete the task safely, I told them about Dr. Pratt's life and her civil rights work. We wore jerseys like the one I am wearing today proudly. And while we worked, we talked and laughed and played music. And it was one of the most joyful, normal afternoons that I've spent in the past year. I think everyone involved walked away feeling happy and proud to be playing a part, honoring one of RCC's brightest stars after the difficult year we've all endured. As part of the draft, we were asked to select a student representative to announce Dr. Pratt as our honoree. I asked my student and RCC photo major, Essence Webb, to represent our school. Essence is such a talented photographer and has worked tirelessly at a pharmacy since the beginning of the pandemic while completing all of her schoolwork. It was only after she accepted the role that I found out she not only knows of Dr. Pratt's legacy, but is lucky enough to call her a family friend. I'd like to invite Essence now to say a few words about their relationship.
Hello, my name is Essence. I wrote a few words about Dr. Pratt. So what do you say about a woman who's done so much for the community and others? As a young girl, I never knew her name. Her name to me was the nice lady with hats. Once I reached the age to understand a bit more about Ms. Pratt, I found out she organized the Martin Luther King Jr. celebration that has been going on in Nyack for 33 years. Dr. Pratt has been my mentor since I started the Nyack NAACP youth branch back in 2012. I am so grateful to have a mentor like her.
Thank you for sharing, Sarah and Essence. Dr. Pratt, you're obviously in amazing company in our SUNY program that is called Art Force 5. Thank you for telling us all about the mural making experience, Sarah. We look forward to seeing the final art installation. Next, we will have remarks from Rockland Community College President, Dr. Michael Baston.
Thank you so much. I am so pleased and so honored to be here to talk about an amazing human being, a humanitarian, one who loves people and one who has made such an indelible mark in the lives of so many, Dr. Francis Pratt. King Solomon once asked a profound question: who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gates. Dr. Frances Pratt is a modern-day Proverbs 31 woman. She speaks the language of love, not simply by what she says, but how she lives her life. It is an honor and a privilege to have her as part of my life, the wife of my wife, and the life of Rockland Community College. We believe that her joy, her love, her inspiration, her concern for the community, her concern for humanity is worthy of lifting up. Thank you, Dr. Pratt, for loving the students. Thank you for loving the community. Thank you for believing that we could be better. Thank you for always giving us a reason to smile and a reason to hope and a reason to believe. Thank you for adorning those lovely hats. Thank you for allowing us to understand the definition of grace, style, dignity, and excellence. And so on behalf of this college and its students and the community, I'm also proud to read part of a proclamation introduced by the Honorable Legislator Harriet D. Cornell. This proclamation comes from the County of Rockland and its legislature. I'd like to read it, a portion of it for you right now. Rockland County, State of New York, in recognition of Dr. Francis Pratt, this March 8th, 2021, Whereas it is incumbent upon this government body to recognize those individuals who provide invaluable services to our community, thereby improving the quality of life that we have come to expect and appreciate. And now, therefore, I, Alden H. Wolf, Chairman of the Rockland County Legislature, take this action to proudly proclaim March 8, 2021 as Dr. Francis Pratt Day in Rockland County. A reason we should all clap our hands and celebrate this amazing, amazing woman who we stand on her shoulders today. And so it is my privilege and my honor to introduce to you Dr. Francis Pratt.
Thank you, Dr. Batson. My father would have been proud of what you said, and my mother would have believed every word. I thank Dr. Batson and trustees and all who have been here to make this possible. I can only say, to God be the glory. Whatever I am or whatever I hope to be, the credit goes first to God and to my mother, who is a faith person and a person of wisdom, in parentheses, a whole heap, to say back sound, with good common sense. And also, Proverbs 18:16 says, your gifts will make room for you and bring you before great men. God did not shortchange anybody. Everybody have a talent, but it's up to you to use your God-given gifts to enhance your talents. And that is what I have tried to do. And as far as the honorable he is also in my club of a son from another mother. I appreciate Melissa and Essence. They were in my youth council branch. And if I have anything to be proud of as the president of the NAACP, and that is to see young people going out, being independent and proud of themselves, regardless of the color of their skin. I know that my pastor is on the line, Pastor Philbert, because I saw that something was in the chat about him. I'm so sorry that y'all won't be able to see him, because he is a specimen of masculinity, cursed with good looks. And it would be nice if you could see him, but if not, Pastor, I thank you for what I saw on the chat. I just would like to use a line in closing from Mr. Cahill, who said, you give little when you give of your possessions. It is when you give yourself that you truly give. And that's what I enjoy best. And Catherine Harper, you are a delight to my soul. I just love you so much. Thank you for your remarks. Thank you.
As I said earlier, Dr. Pratt, we love what you do and we love how you do it. Thank you for everything you've done to make Rockland County better for all of us. We are thrilled to have close to 100 people register with us today, including members of the RCC and local communities. Thank you everyone for joining us to celebrate this wonderful woman. We'd like to extend thanks to the Nyack branch of the NAACP, Doria Hillsman, Colette Fournier, and the county legislature for the roles they played in making today's program possible. Of course, we want to thank the program participants, last but certainly not least, for sharing their thoughts and their gifts to allow us to truly honor this woman in a way that we can be proud of, because she always does so much for us. Of course, I also want to thank Strategic Marketing for allowing us to share in this Zoom experience today. Thank you for joining us. Have a wonderful day.